There is something really interesting that happens as we move through the kinos that we say over Tisha B'Av. If you look through the kinos, we spend a lot of time talking about terrible tragedies and horrors and persecutions through Jews throughout history, whether in our relationship with God that has been severed, or how the other nations have treated us like filth and dirt. But as we move through the kinos and we get to the end, we read a kina that seems to not be that bad. The Kina Sha'alis Rufa Be'esh, which is written by the Maharam Mirutenberg, discusses the book burning in Paris in 1242. Yes, it was a terrible event. King Louis IX takes 24 wagon loads of Sfarim and of books and of manuscripts and burns them in a fire. Works of Rishonim, commentaries on Torah, on Mishnayos, on Gemara, on Halacha, that we'll never know and we'll never read. But nobody was hurt. Nobody was killed. And nobody was exiled. So why do we make a kina? Why do we make such a big deal about this event? And I believe that perhaps we need to look at the event and what made the Maharam so nervous. And Rabbi Soloveitchik once noted that perhaps the Maharam realized that maybe our enemies are onto us. You see, when they exiled us, and when they persecuted us, and when they kicked us around, we still had the Torah that connected us together. But now, maybe they realize that if they get to our Torah, to our lifeline, and they burn that, and they burn all of the Chumashim, and all of the Mishnayos, and all of the works on philosophy, and history, and Halacha, and Gemara, what will we have? And the Maharam is nervous that perhaps Torah Sheba Al Peh will be lost forever. So he pens this kina full of fear and of fright, not just for the Jewish people, but for the eternity of the Jewish people. What will it be? And while he ends on a positive note, the Maharam does not know. The Maharam has spent his last 8 years of his life in prison, dedicating himself, writing, teaching Torah to the same Torah he was worried about losing. And yet, here we stand today. An explosion of Torah learning. The Rav notes how in that time after 1242, people rededicated themselves because of this fear, reinvested themselves in their learning. Tisha B'Av is about perspective. We talk about the past tragedies, what has gone wrong in our relationships with each other and with God. We look at the present, how we don't have a full base, Geula, at a Beis HaMikdash, peace and unity amongst the nations and amongst the Jewish people. And that should propel us to be inspired for the future. What we do today, when we realize perspective-wise, is that we can look back to the Maharam and we can say, look what we have. And look what we can continue to build on. We have an explosion of Torah learning today. An accessibility to Torah learning today. And that should motivate us to reinvest and to rededicate to the lifeline, to what we thought was almost lost many, many years ago. Rav Moshe Scherer was the great leader of the Aguda, used to carry a document with him. And it was a letter written by a German commander to his other lieutenants. And he wrote to them that for any price, you can let a Jew escape. But there is one kind of Jew you cannot let escape. The Talmud Shayid, the Jew who learns. Because this German commander wrote with his alphabet, with his Aleph base, they can regenerate everything. It's the power of the Torah, the power of the letters that binds us together and allows us to close the gap and to motivate us more to close the gap. Our relationship with God and with each other.